Hello students, this is Parth Thakkar. In our today's video, we are going to learn one most important topic from the radiation chapter, which is a radiation shield. So let's start with the first slide. There are so many situations where it is required to reduce the overall heat transfer between two surfaces which are radiating at each other. In that situation, it can be reduced greatly by inserting a thin, highly reflective sheet, and with the help of this highly reflective sheet, we can reduce the heat transfer rate because of the radiation. That highly reflective sheet is known as the radiation shield. The role of the radiation shield is to reduce the rate of radiation heat transfer by placing additional resistance in the path of radiation heat flow. From this figure, you can see there are three plates. This is plate number one, this is plate number two, which are parallel to each other, and this is the radiation shield which is inserted between plate one and plate two. Suppose temperature of plate one is T1 and emissivity epsilon 1. Similarly, for plate two, temperature is T2 and emissivity epsilon 2. Below this is a resistance for the electromagnetic wave, which we have learned in electrical analogy in previous video, that if electromagnetic wave emitted from surface 1 and incident on surface 2, then for that electromagnetic wave, the first resistance is surface resistance, which is offered by surface 1, which is 1 minus epsilon 1 upon epsilon 1 into A1. Now between plate 1 and plate 2, there is a surface resistance, and again when that electromagnetic wave incident on surface 2, there is again a surface resistance of plate 2, which is 1 minus epsilon 2 upon epsilon 2 into A2. So when there is a no shield between plate 1 and 2, when there is a no radiation shield is inserted between plate 1 and plate 2, at that time the heat transfer rate Q1 to 2 can be written as area into sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 upon 1 upon epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1. We have already derived this 1 upon 1 upon epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1 gray body factor for parallel plates in our previous lecture. So when there is a no shield between plate 1 and plate 2, then heat transfer rate can be calculated by using this equation. Now if we consider of reflectivity of this shield, then because of this shield, the heat transfer rate between surface 1 and surface 2 can be calculated by using this equation. From electrical analogy, there is Q1 to 2 by inserting one shield, EB1 minus EB2. EB1 is emissive power of this surface and EB2 is emissive power of this surface. So EB1 minus EB2 divided by the total resistance between EB1 and EB2. So first resistance is the surface resistance, which is offered by plate 1, which is 1 minus epsilon 1 upon epsilon 1 into A1. Now this electromagnetic wave will travel up to the shield, so there is a space resistance between plate 1 and the shield, which is 1 upon A1 F123. Now when that electromagnetic wave reaches to the surface of the shield, again there is a surface resistance which is offered by the shield, which is 1 minus epsilon 31, because this is the side which is facing surface 1, so that the emissivity of this side is denoted by epsilon 3 comma 1 upon epsilon 31 A3. Now from this surface, the electromagnetic wave when emits, it faces surface resistance by the shield, which is again 1 minus epsilon 32, because this side of emissivity of shield can be denoted by epsilon 32 upon epsilon 32 into A3. Now it travels between shield and surface 2, so there is again a space resistance which is 1 upon A3 F32, because our shield is our surface 3. So electromagnetic wave is traveling from surface 3 to surface 2, so space resistance would be 1 upon A3 into F32. Now that electromagnetic wave is going to incident on surface 2, so again it faces surface resistance, which is 1 minus epsilon 2 upon epsilon 2 into A2. So between EB1 and EB2, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 there are 7 resistance. So summation of this all the resistance in Eb1 minus Eb2 divided by this all resistance. So by using this equation we can calculate heat transfer rate with one shield. But here we know that F1 to 3, the electromagnetic wave which are going to be emitted from this parallel plate surface 1 is directly going to incident on this shield, because both the surface are exactly parallel to each other. The similarly it is shield and surface 2 are also exactly parallel, so F13 is equal to F23 is equal to 1. Also these are infinite parallel plates, so area A1 is equal to A2 is equal to A3 is equal to A. Putting these values in this equation, we will get Q12 for one shield with the one shield can be calculated. Instead of Eb1 we can write sigma T1 raised to 4, instead of Eb2 we can write sigma T2 raised to 4, so area sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 upon 1 plus epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 3 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 3 2 minus 1. If the emissivity of both side of the shield is the same, then the equation would further simplify. Instead of this 1 upon epsilon 3 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 3 2, it would be 2 by epsilon 3. Suppose the emissivity of the both side of the shield is epsilon 3, then in this equation this term would be 2 upon epsilon 3 minus 1. So if there is 2 radiation shield, then this in this equation only plus 2 by epsilon 4 minus 1 would be added. If there are 3 radiation shield between surface 1 and surface 2, then again one more term is going to be added, which is 2 divided by epsilon 5 plus 1. Okay, so as the number of shield increases, the only one term is going to be added in the resistance. Done. So in this figure, this is surface 1, a parallel plate 1, this is parallel plate 2. In between 1 and 2 there is one radiation shield whose emissivity is epsilon 3 on the both sides. The emissivity of surface 1 is epsilon 1, surface 2 is epsilon 2, and for the radiation shield emissivity at the both sides is epsilon 3. Now from the electrical analogy, this is the Eb1, the emissive power of plate 1, Eb2 emissive power of plate 2. Between Eb1 and Eb2 there are surface resistance and space resistance which is offered by surface 1, 2 and 3. But radiation shield do not generate any heat. So whatever the amount of heat which is transferred from surface 1 to the surface 3, it will be transferred from surface 3 to surface 2. Radiation shield only reduces the heat transfer rate. It not add or remove any extra heat. Okay. So Q122 net without any radiation shield can be calculated by using this equation: area into sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 upon 1 plus epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1. This is for the without radiation shield. This equation can be used for without radiation shield. Now heat transfer rate between 1 and 3 can be calculated, just only one change. Instead of this epsilon 2 we can write epsilon 3 for the 1 and 3. Instead of T2 raised to 4 it would be T3 raised to 4. Similarly for 3 to 2 here it would become 1 upon epsilon 3 and 1 upon epsilon 2, temperature difference T3 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4. Since the radiation shield does not deliver or remove heat from the system, Q122 net with shield can be calculated by using this equation, which is area sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 upon 1 plus epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 3 minus 1, which is this equation, plus this 1 upon epsilon 3 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1. Or we can simplify this equation in the form of 1 upon epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1 plus 2 upon epsilon 3 minus 1. So now let's calculate some numerical which is based on radiation shield. Calculate the net radiation heat transfer per meter square area of two large plates placed parallel to each other are at temperature of 427 and 27 degrees Celsius respectively. The emissivity of hot plate is 0.9 and cold plate is 0.6. If a polished aluminium shield is placed between them, then find out the percentage of reduction in the heat transfer. The emissivity of shield is given as a 0.04. So here we have two plates. This is two parallel plates and this is one radiation shield which is introduced between them. The emissivity of plate 1 is 0.9, plate 2 is 0.6, the temperature is 427 and 27 respectively. The emissivity of shield is 0.04. Now, we want to find out the percentage of reduction by introducing radiation shield. So first we find out heat transfer rate without radiation shield. So without radiation shield we can find out heat transfer rate from surface 1 to 2 by using this equation. Here we have considered area is 1 because in question it is asked net radiation heat transfer per meter square. So taking A1 is equal to A2 is equal to A3 is equal to 1. So equation would be sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 upon 1 plus epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1. We know the value of T1, T2, epsilon 1, epsilon 2 and sigma. Putting the value, the answer would be Q1 to 2 without shield would be 7399.35 watt per meter square. This heat transfer rate is for the without shield. Now, if we introduce radiation shield with the emissivity of 0.04, now heat transfer rate between surface 1 and 2 would be calculated by using this equation sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 divided by 1 upon epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1 plus 2 upon epsilon 3 minus 1. As we have derived this equation in our previous slides, we know value of epsilon 1, epsilon 2, epsilon 3, T1 and T2. So by putting this all value, we will get Q1 to 2 with shield, which is 259 watt per meter square. So from the answer we can see that there is a reduction in heat transfer by introducing radiation shield. Now we want to calculate percentage of reduction in rate. So it can be calculated by Q without minus Q with divided by Q without into 100. So it would be 1 minus Q with upon Q without. Q with means heat transfer rate with shield. Q without means heat transfer rate without shield. So putting the answer we will get that is a reduction of 96.49% by using radiation shield. Clear? Moving to the next question. Two large parallel plates with emissivity of 0.5 each are maintained at different temperatures and are exchanging heat only by radiation. Two equally large shields with the surface emissivity of 0.05 are introduced in parallel to plates. Find the percentage reduction in net radiative heat transfer. So here, two radiation shields are introduced between two surfaces. So from figure you can see that we have two parallel plates, surface 1 and surface 2, whose temperature are T1 and T2 with emissivity 0.5. There are two radiation shields which are introduced between these two plates with emissivity of 0.05. Now to find out percentage of reduction, first we are going to find out heat transfer rate without shield. So without shield we can easily find out by using this equation, which is sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 upon 1 upon epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1. Here area is considered as a 1. So by putting the value here, emissivity of both the surfaces, both the plates are 0.5, which is given in question. T1 and T2 is unknown, but if we want to know only reduction in percentage, then there is no need of temperature. So putting T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 as it is, just putting value of emissivity which is 0.5, we will get 0.33 sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4. This is the heat transfer rate without shield. Now we are going to calculate heat transfer rate with two shield. So when there is a when we introduce two shield between two surface 1 and 2, the equation would be modified or simplified in this way. Sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 remains as it is, upon 1 upon epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1 as it is, plus this term is for the one radiation shield which is given as surface 3. This term is for the surface 4, which is another radiation shield. 2 upon epsilon 3 minus 1 and 2 upon epsilon 3 minus 1, epsilon 4 minus 1. We know the value of this epsilon 3 and epsilon 4 emissivity of a shield, which is 0.05. So 0.05 and 0.05. We will get 0.0123 sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4. This is the heat transfer rate with two radiation shield. So if we want to calculate percentage of reduction, again we can calculate by using 1 minus Q with shield upon Q without shield into 100. Putting the value sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 will be cancelled out. So there is 96.27% of reduction by using 2 radiation shield with emissivity of 0.05. Moving towards the next question. Determine net radiation heat transfer per meter square for two infinite parallel plates held at temperature of 800 Kelvin and 500 Kelvin respectively. Emissivity of hot and cold plates are 0.6 and 0.4 respectively. Now, it is intended to reduce the heat transfer by 40% of original value. I repeat once again. It is intended to reduce the heat transfer to 40% of original value by placing a radiation shield between them. Calculate the emissivity of the shield and its equilibrium temperature. Okay. So first, there is a two surface which is maintained at T1 and T2. The temperature is this T1 and T2 is 800 and 500 Kelvin. The emissivity are epsilon 1 and epsilon 2. Value is 0.6 and 0.4. Now, you are supposed to put one radiation shield between surface 1 and 2, and by putting this radiation shield, you have to decrease heat transfer rate by 40% of original value. So, you have to find out what would be the emissivity of this radiation shield, that heat transfer rate is going to reduce by 40% of original value. So, first, we need to find out heat transfer rate without shield. So, Q122 without shield can be calculated by using this equation sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 upon 1 plus epsilon 1 plus 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1. We know the value of epsilon 1, epsilon 2, T1 and T2. So by putting this value in this equation, Q122 heat transfer rate from surface 1 to 2 without shield would be 6216.2 watt per meter square. Now by putting radiation shield, heat transfer is going to reduce by 40% of original value. So, suppose now with shield, heat transfer rate between Q1 to 2 should be 0.4, 40% of without shield. So, 40% of 6216.2. So, our new heat transfer rate by placing radiation shield should be 2486.48 watt per meter square. So, now we know the value Q1 to 2 with the shield. Now, under steady state condition, we know Q122 is equal to 123 is equal to Q322. So, Q122 with shield, the equation for the with shield heat transfer rate would be sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 upon 1 plus epsilon 1, 1 upon epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1 plus 2 upon epsilon 3 minus 1. Epsilon 3 is emissivity of radiation shield. In this equation, we know value of this Q122 with shield, which is 2486.4. Value of sigma is 5.67 into 10 raised to minus 8. T1 and T2 is 800 and 500. We know value of epsilon 1 and epsilon 2, which is 0.6 and 0.4. So in this equation, only epsilon 3 emissivity of radiation shield is unknown. So by calculating this equation, we would get emissivity of radiation shield should be 0.3, so that you can reduce heat transfer rate by 40%. If you want to calculate the temperature of radiation shield, you can calculate by using this equation Q123 is equal to, or you can also use equation Q223. So sigma T1 raised to 4 minus T3 raised to 4 upon 1 upon epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 3 minus 1. In this equation, only T3 is unknown. Remaining all term is known for us, so you can easily calculate value of T3. Or you can calculate value of T3 by using Q223. Then the equation would be sigma T2 raised to 4 minus T3 raised to 4 upon 1 upon epsilon 2 plus 1 upon epsilon 3 minus 1. So the temperature of the radiation shield would be 708.9 Kelvin. So that's it for today. This is how you can solve numerical for the radiation shield. Radiation shield is the most important topic. It is used to reduce the heat transfer rate between two surfaces which transfer heat with the radiation. Thank you so much.